Europe in general or the European Union members in general will really have to decide what it is that they understand this union to mean. Obviously, responsibility as a member is part of the equation, but solidarity was meant to be the other. I really suspect that the next few years, if the EU is going to be a sustainable entity, will have to be devoted to defining what the balance is between responsibilities and solidarity. I personally think that Turkey could play a role in this definition of Europe. So if you are situated north to south and east to west there where Turkey is, you cannot not be an important player in world politics, not just in your own neighborhood. The role I think fits Turkey best is to be a mediator, because I think one advantage Turkey has that it can speak the language of all its neighbors, and that is an advantage that not many countries have. One of the things that Turkey can do, therefore, is to sensitize the Europeans. The Middle East is already in Europe. I mean, it is contiguous with Europe. Plus, Europeans have participated in the making of the modern Middle East. And finally, there are plenty of Middle Easterners who live in Europe. They're unlikely to leave. So I think to really think that you can actually set yourself like a medieval castle away from those dangerous creatures is just delusional. I'm glad that the Bosch Foundation Stiftung allowed the academy to be present in Berlin rather than in Stuttgart. Because when you're in Berlin, you can see, as the capital of New Germany, of unified Germany, there's a different perception of Europe, of the world as well. Or I actually believe that the academy will play a very important role in creating the fundamentals for that vision that I thought for Europe to have. Germany is the leader of Europe. And it's kind of like trying to get used to being the leader. So one has to understand how the German system works, how the Germans think, and what the German public opinion responds to.